another day in the sport.
My feeling is that you feel pressure when you aren't prepared to do something. So if you practice them very hard during the course of the week, prepare them fundamentally, then the night before the game, then I would get them all in the room. I want them to relax. I want them to perceive what was going to happen tomorrow.
Relaxation is what he would call it. We would we'd go to the pep rally. We'd go right over here to the Loftus Center. He'd turn all the lights out in the Loftus Center, and he'd lay us all out on the floor.
We'd all be laying flat on our backs. Lights were dim, and he would talk to us for, it felt like 2 or 3 hours, but I think it was about maybe 20 or 30 minutes.
And he'd just start talking to us, hey, you know, relax your right arm, you know, let it sink into the carpet, relax your left arm, let it sink into the carpet, you know, relax your left foot, relax your right foot, relax your neck, feel your body slipping into the carpet.
He would sink us into the carpet, get us really relaxed. Some guys would fall asleep, and then he would put us through a game. Basically, and it was his game and his mind that we all got in sync together with.
Once you have them in a clear, relaxed position, then you get them to think about all the positive things in their life, how fortunate they are to be at Notre Dame, to have the family they have, to be with the teammates that they have. And once you get them in a positive frame of mind, thinking about very positive, then you go through the game. We're in the locker room before the game. Look around, see your teammates. You come out on the field. You describe the uniform you're wearing, then describe the uniform the other team's wearing, and then about being in the huddle, like it's 3rd down and 8, the play's called. See the ball snap. See you carrying out your execution perfectly.
He told us to envision, you know, catching the game-winning touchdown or envision making the game-winning block.
Visualize you making a great play. Visualize you making the tackle, you making the big catch, you know, you making the big block. You know, just visualize success.
Then I would culminate it by being in the locker room after the game. The great feeling you have with your teammates coming out of the locker room. There's your girlfriend, your parents, your friends. And then I culminate it last with the locker room in the bowl game after we've won.
The goal at the end was the national championship. You know, see yourself, you know, raising your arms or, you know, winning the championship, making a play that helps propel your team to win.
It was always about the positives and what we were going to do well and who was making plays, and he had this vision, and some of those visions came true, believe it or not.
So many times it happened just the way we talked about. I remember one time I talked about Alan Rossum returning the opening kickoff and how everything was good, and it worked out that way. If your mind perceives something, the body can achieve it.
Yeah, you know, you'd be laying there, you know, just totally relaxed, just with these great thoughts in your head, and you know, you almost wanted to get up and, like, you know, just tackle somebody right then. You just get so excited and you get the goosebumps, and you know, it was a really, really cool experience.
He was a master manipulator in terms of getting our minds right. A psychologist, just that kind of thing was phenomenal.
More players talk about that one thing, the relaxation period, than anything else. And I do it myself, and I want them to do it the rest of their life when they're in a difficult situation. But remember this, pressure's when you have to do something you aren't prepared to do. My obligation, coach, was do everything I possibly could to prepare them so that they would not feel any pressure.